Cole, with those last two wickets, where does that put you in the game now, and how do you feel now with those wickets going into tomorrow?
I think we're probably still a bit behind the game, but I think those two wickets sort of bring us back into it a little bit. I think there's a bit of a window open for us now. It would have been nice when we had them 27 for three to sort of get a couple more then. But I think these two at the end sort of give us a bit of hope going into tomorrow. If we can start off well, then I think we'll be in with a chance of sort of setting something up in this game, hopefully.
Kyle, you and Travis were the ones who got half centuries and beyond. Do you think it's a kind of pitch where you have to show some positive intent to be able to survive and to score runs?
I don't think you necessarily have to sort of take that approach, but I think it's definitely an approach on this wicket that seems to have worked for the two of us. But I mean, Steve Smith also batted really nicely, and he sort of looked to just take his time and set the game up. So I think it's not necessarily a specific approach that you need to take on this wicket. I feel like it's a really good batting wicket, to be honest. I think myself and Travis are both probably quite positive approaching players, and I think that sort of just worked today. But yeah, I think it's a really good batting wicket, and I think yeah, just normal game plans should be good.
Can you just give us an idea what it was like out there? You say it was a good pitch, but then with the fast bowling and quality of it that we saw today, both from a perspective of batting and then keeping?
I think, yeah, when I say it's a good pitch, it's probably more just going on what it looks like. I think when you see a pitch that's so green, you probably expect it to do so much. And yeah, I think this probably did a lot less than what we thought. It wasn't as soft as I think we would expect with the grass cover that there was. I think the wicket was actually quite firm, and there was a decent amount of pace and bounce in it. So I think, yeah, when I speak about it being a good wicket, I mean, it's probably just better than what we expected it to be. Yeah, I think especially when we got bowled out for 150 odd, I think it's as much as you want to try and get the energies up, it is quite difficult. So when you get a wicket, sort of first ball of the innings, and when it's a big player like David Warner, I think that just lifts everyone up. And I think for the next sort of 10 overs, we carried that energy and that sort of adrenaline that we got from that ball. We carried it through the next 10 overs and got those next two wickets. And I think that, yeah, sort of set us up quite nicely. Yeah, I think unfortunately we sort of fell away a bit for the next sort of 10 over period or so. But yeah, it was definitely a massive moment in the game for us.
Kyle, you've obviously kept a fair bit to those quick bowlers over this year. How did that little session compare in terms of how they were hitting the gloves? And do you think some of them still have a bit more gas in the tank? You suggested the pitch, it might quicken up tomorrow. Do you think it might even fly through a little bit more?
Yeah, definitely. I think definitely after lunch, it seemed to pick up a bit more pace, and then towards the end of the day, it seemed like Anas was starting to get it through quite nicely. So, yeah, I think it's definitely a bit left in the tank for our bowlers. I think, like you said, the pitch is probably going to quicken up a little bit tomorrow if there's a bit of sun out. So, yeah, it'll be interesting to see how it goes. Yeah, hopefully our bowlers can come with a bit of energy tomorrow and sort of make an impact. Yeah, I think fortunately I've played a decent amount of first class cricket, and I bat a bit higher up the order domestically. So yeah, I've sort of been in similar situations like this in the past and been able to be reasonably successful in those situations. So for myself, although it's a bigger stage and you're playing international cricket, you always have that reference point of having done it previously for your domestic side. So I just look to sort of take confidence in that and stick to the approaches that I took back home, and fortunately today it sort of went okay. So yeah.
You mentioned the significance of the Warner wicket there. Rabada, he seems to relish those battles with big players. Is that something that he really takes on?
Yeah, I think with KG, he's someone that he always sort of targets the big players. I think he's one of those guys. I don't know what the stats are, but I reckon he's probably gets the he's probably got the highest percentage of getting the top three or four batters out against everyone that he plays. I think that's something that he's really good at. He's our main bowler, obviously. And yeah, if we need someone to sort of crack a game open or get the opposition's big name players out, he's always the guy we look to go to. Something that he loves doing, and he does it really, really well.
Kyle, there obviously has been a fair bit of discussion about the batting and collapses that have happened sort of in recent times. So what was sort of the feeling when you come off after an innings like that as a team, knowing that you probably haven't quite put the runs on the board that you would like to?
I think the initial feeling is probably a bit of disappointment, but then you sort of look around in the change room at our four quicks and our spinner that you have, and I think everyone sort of gets excited again and thinks, oh, well, we've got 150 on the board, that might actually be enough with what we've got in the change room. So I think that's sort of the space that we're in at the moment. That's the approach we're looking to take. Obviously, as batters, we need to be better, but I think with our bowling lineup that we have, I think, to be honest, any score that we get, there's a bit of belief that our bowlers can do a job with what's on the board.